Published 0758 EDT, the 13th of August 2017. Updated 0818 EDT, the 13th of August 2017. It's been something of a testing week for the royal family after the broadcast of tapes of intimate revelations by Princess Diana, casting an unflattering light upon everyone from the Queen to Prince Charles and Camilla, but there was no hint of turmoil this morning as members of the royal family joined the Queen for Sunday service at Balmoral as she continues her summer break at her Scottish residence. Her Majesty perfectly turned out as usual in a lime green ensemble complete with a matching hat, and travelled to church with a cheerful Prince Andrew. Also joining the party was Prince Edward and his wife Sophie and daughter Lady Louise. Charles and his wife Camilla travelled to church in another car with the Duchess of Cornwall flashing a cheerful smile to photographers as they whizzed past. It's been a particular embarrassing week for Charles and Camilla after the recordings Diana made with voice coach Peter Settlin were broadcast on Channel 4, revealing how the late royal had battled with the knowledge that her husband was in love with another woman right from the beginning. The Queen looked resplendent in green as she was driven to church with Prince Andrew at Balmoral. The past was dredged up again this week when intimate recordings of Princess Diana discussing Charles and Camilla's affair was broadcast, but the Duchess did not look ruffled. "I remember saying to my husband, 'You know, why is this Lady Camilla around?' And he said, 'Well, I refuse to be the only Prince of Wales who never had the mistress,'" she told Settlin. The Queen also came off somewhat unfavourably as Diana recalled going to the top lady for advice on how to save her marriage. The response she received was, "I don't know what you should do. Charles is hopeless." And it seemed there was little support from the Duke of Edinburgh, who Diana claimed had told Charles, "If your marriage doesn't work out, you can always go back to her after 5 years. Prince Edward was behind the wheel to drive his wife Sophie and daughter Lady Louise to church. Settlin was hired by the princess to build her confidence in public speaking, but in the process recorded her no-holds-barred confessions about the royals. He began recording interviews with Diana in September 1992, 3 months before her official split with Prince Charles. They continued to meet and record until December 1993. The broadcast of the tapes was hugely controversial, with royal fans arguing they should be kept private because of the nature of Diana's revelations. Everyone looked in good spirits, including Prince Edward. Despite the embarrassment of Diana's intimate revelations being broadcast, she spoke frankly about her sex life with Charles, adding, "It was odd, very odd. But it was there. Then it fizzled out about 7 years ago. 6 years ago? Well, seven, because Harry was eight. Instinct told me. It was just so odd. I don't know. There was no requirement for it from his case. Sort of once every 3 weeks, and I kept thinking. And then I followed a pattern. He used to see his lady once every 3 weeks before we got married." One of Diana's close friends, Rosa Monckton, called for a boycott of the intrusive Channel 4 documentary. Diana, in her own words,